Hello, fluffy people of the world. My name is Liquid Blitz, and welcome back to BioShock. Now, okay, it's been a few days since I last recorded, but I've gone back through all these radio messages from the insane artist guy just to refresh in my mind where we are, and this radio message in particular explains where we are.
And there's Fitzpatrick, freed of his own kinks and defects. And here's the glorious news.
What? Subtitles is great.
This is just the moment of conception. Out in this place, there are three men, all former disciples of mine, all connected by a common thread.
We're killing these disciples.
Find them, little moth, and immortalize their mortality in my quadtic. Go. Once they've been sent to their reward, you shall go to yours.
And got it. So, because obviously 3 days, I think I haven't played this game for like 3 days, so I forgot everything. So, Sandor the Madman Artist wants us to kill his three disciples who betrayed him or whatever, so I've checked our goals. We've got literally got to kill three dudes. I don't know if all three are... through that frosty door we ended on, which leads to this whole double area here. And I've got three little sisters to rescue in just this area, so that's... we're probably going to get all three in this episode. But I don't know if just one guy is going to be over here. Because it's not that big an area. In fact, shouldn't it show the goal on the screen somewhere? I guess not. Well, anyway... I believe, we've got 180 pointage, and we'd need one more plasmid slot to max it out, so I figured, let's just buy it. Achievement unlocked, maxed one track. Indeed. I've only got the one thing, I think? Yeah. Don't need to see that again. Right, I've got 80 more points. We'll be getting a bunch from saving these three little girls, little sisters, probably in this episode, so... and maybe a reward as well. So let's just spend this here and now. Goddamn, I don't know. Things are getting harder, so I might go for, like, more health. Increase my max health. I've gone for, like, two EVE upgrades, or three, and no health, so let's go health this time. Whenever I face a Big Daddy or whoever, my health is slamming empty constantly, so I need it. That's what we're talking about right there. And we've got Security Bullseye, which I haven't used before. I'll leave it for now. Right, let's do this then. I mean... I've had a quick, brief look at the map, and I think there's a bunch of places we couldn't go yet. I think. I think. Let's just go where we're supposed to go. Anything we need?
Welcome to the circus.
We're all good. Now we've just got the crossbow as well. We've got steel tip bolts. I'm gonna save these for some tough motherfuckers. Incendiary and normal. I might use this to kill the named story guys.
I can see your breath.
What the fuck? Marta, that was one of the three guys I've got to kill it. Okay.
You think you're gonna finish me in here, you old fruit? In the saps you tossed in this meat locker, I'll panic like rabbits. I just watched and waited. And when they started to kick, I started to scavenge. Made myself a little... splicer cocktail I did.
Look at this guy's just as crazy.
From the cold, and you gotta grow ice over your heart.
Anybody there?
And the Iceman cometh, Sander baby. The Iceman fucking cometh.
The Iceman fucking cometh. Hang on, that door's been locked behind me. Who the fuck just ran past me and away from me? Okay, let's just ignore that. The treble on that guy's radio message then was crazy. That was like piercingly loud treble and no bass. just like an old school tape recording, but even like extra treble. But anyway. So this guy's just a crazy bastard. He actually probably deserves to die. Oh, is this him? Hmm. Interesting. Somebody said, by the way, in the comments, it's a bit late now, but somebody said that the thing that turns me invisible actually creates a known bug where it can prevent you making any progress because somebody doesn't spawn when you get to Fort Frolic, apparently. But I think I'm already in Fort Frolics and I'm continuing, so it looks like I'm good for now. I wonder if these ice people are going to come to life, like, for real. Oh! Can I... Am I just fucked? Have I fucked it?
Guess the old grape finally sent someone.
Hello, with your bird mask. Can
son
I break out
bitch.
This?
Left me to freeze.
Freeze. Can you break me out, please?
I've got a pose all picked out for you.
Oh, so this guy's like an artist as well. Just like Sandor. Well, at least he melted me. That was kind of him. Am I in the same... Hang on. We are in the same room, aren't we? I wanted to melt this shit. Oh, shit! Frozen enemies can be easily killed, but they shatter, leaving no loot. Yeah, somebody told me that in a comment. Well, can I release some people? They just look like basic splices right now. I think they're all good. Kill them all, fuck them. What's he firing at me? Okay, what the fuck splicer is this? This guy needs a camera shot or two. Just a thuggish basic splicer. He's firing frost bolts at me like a fucking WoW mage. Ow. I need more pictures. Oh, shit, I know. Okay. Let's fire his frost bolt straight back at him. This guy doesn't give a fuck. Unless these are really weak ice things. You know what? Let's fire a trash can at him. Shit. Is that a brick? Missed. Okay, now. Oh, Jesus. Right, hang on.
Get over here!
I need to defrost the trash can to fire it at him. Fuck you! Fuck you!
That was...
Oh, that was him!
Take a photo of him and place it in the quad tick. I'm feeling full, like an expectant mama.
I should have known that was him. I just thought that was a super strong splicer for some reason. Frozen Field. Ooh! Leave your foes out in the cold with Frozen Field. I'm not sure how much I'm going to lean into the icy stuff because I like loot, you know what I'm saying? You take less damage from cold and can freeze enemies when you hit them. I don't really like that. I need me some loot from my kills. I don't know why I thought that was a regular splicer. I guess when it said thuggish splicer, it was the splicer behind this dude that I photographed. So he could just like... He did say on the radio message he's made a cocktail, like a plasmid cocktail or whatever. And I see that. He can literally throw ice, which is pretty cool. Let's just melt everything, because you never know. Well, that's... Okay, that was easier than I thought it was going to be. One guy down. Two to go. I've got to take a picture. Let's capture a really good angle. I wish I could go prone. Just go full fucking Mark Jefferson on him. Was something walking around in the background then? Good enough. Now, do we go back and get our reward from this one guy? That's a shit photograph.
Yes! Now, put the picture in the frame.
Okay.
Let's see what we've got here.
Ooh, I can take his mask. Put it on his face. Right, any other shit in here? I'll just heal. Anything stuck in ice? I swear to fuck, the trash can is one of the strongest weapons in this game. It kills guys in one. In fact, didn't it kill this Finnegan guy in one, once I actually fucking hit him and didn't miss? Are we getting some... I need to create or buy some AP rounds for this, like anti-personnel red ones, because I've got none. Now, let's go. Hang on a second, drop this. Can I not go, like, right down there? Oh, ho, 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 ho. Oh, hell yes, you can. I'm gonna have a quick save it. Well, this episode started with a fucking bang. So I'm guessing these three guys are all just crazy people. Just like Sandor. Big Daddy! Now, I've been told, people have been increasingly telling me that the Big Daddies are passive, like, increasingly so. So I thought they were just passive if you kept a distance at first. Then I thought they were just passive as long as they didn't have a little sister. Apparently, once and for all, somebody is like, just told me how they work. They are passive all the fucking time, even if they've got a little sister with them. Even with a little sister on their back, apparently they are passive. What the fuck am I looking at? Oh! That scared the shit out of me. Jesus, fuck it. Right in my face. I'm fucked. Can I take a backup picture really fast? And fill that bar. Nice. Ooh. Oh, thank God for that more damage. Right. Let's whip out the shotgun. One shot kill. Get off the floor. Off the ceiling. Okay, either I'm getting real... Either that plus damage that I just got is super strong, or these guys have suddenly got weak. It's like a one-shot kill. Where are all these motherfuckers? I don't even need a trash can at this rate.
Call the cops on me!
It's come to my attention as well that the shotgun, the way it actually works like a real shotgun, there's pellets that can hit or miss with a single shot. So if I need to, like, aim center mass, and I'll do maximum damage. Still don't know what that's saying. I'm gonna hack this because I might buy some more crossbow bolts and shit. Because that seems like, hey, I'm all for bows and crossbows, you know? Fuck a pistol and an SMG when I've got a crossbow. Right, God help me. The hacking is seemingly ridiculous now. It started easy at the start of the game, now it's ridiculous. Upper left, up there, and then we go up, and then we go right, top right, and... No, top right, you motherfucker. Then we need some horizontally boys. We need more horizontally boys, and then, like, one more horizontally boy. We need another horizontally boy! No! Oh, we don't have a horizontally boy. Unless my eyes are failing me. Just auto-hack it, goddammit. Right. I'm definitely liking the sound of incendiary bolts. Let's buy six. Oh, that's it, and it's gone. Oh, well, let's buy the normal ones. by another 6. There we go. Good enough. I might finally also start using proximity mines. I haven't used any in the game. In fact, let's use one. Let's do.
Come back! I didn't mean anything by it.
I need this guy. Come on down. Come on through to the other side.
Remember, bandits are parasites. Vandalism is a serious crime. Remember.
Let's go invisible. This is the... Okay, if you are officially invisible with this tonic from the alarm shit, it's the most overpowered mechanic in this game. Are they going to attack me or not? That's the question. I don't think so. I might just take a breather. That's ridiculous. I mean, you sort of got to wait for like 40 seconds, but that's ridiculous. There's like no consequence. Done. Big daddy here. Oh, a little sit. Right. Okay. Let's see if they officially attack you. Quick save. But yeah, that's ridiculous. This is so overpowered, turning invisible. I'm wondering if...
Get off!
His eyes are still yellow. No, he hasn't gone red. By the way, this is a new kind of Big Daddy. You can tell it is. The first Big Daddy in the game looks similar, bulky, unlike the rosy second model, which is skinnier and throws proximity mines. This looks like the first one, except the drill arm is... It was like a drill before, now it's a spinny thing, so this is definitely a different kind. And while that little sister is here, apparently you can scan them, so I'm going to scan the shit out of them. Oh, no, it is a bouncer. Officially, it is the same one. Okay. Scratch everything I just said. It's just got a slightly different looking arm. Increased damage, thank you. They are vulnerable to armor piercing. That's nice to know. It did start to get pissed off though when I got close. I wonder if proximity is still a thing. I need to kill this guy and rescue the little sister, so. Hang on, little sister research bonus. Small increases to max health and Eve. What, just like that? Dude, can I scan again? Oh, she just yelled Mr. Bubbles and then pointed at me. You might as well. I mean, you might as well keep scanning until you get nothing from him. I don't see why not. I wonder if that's just like a threatening stance.
There's rainbows. Time to find the angel.
Oh, is she literally running away from me? Oh, he's getting antsy and he's pantsy. I think that man is gone, Mr. B. I'm right here.
You get away!
Okay, let's see. Let's stop taking fucking pictures. I need to switch to the electro buckshot because that can stun these motherfuckers. But let's see if they officially get pissed off if you're face to face with them. It would be funny if you could literally scoop the girl up and just run away. You know what I mean? Well, it's now or never. I'm gonna quick save after I've... Jesus, that's loud. I'm gonna quick save after I've researched the shit out of them. It's you and me, motherfucker! Shit! I need to use these pillars like a professional. It's all about the pillars. He's trying to get into a position to charge. And he's failing. Pillars, pillars, pillars. Okay, these... Whoa! Done. I'm sorry. Sorry, not sorry.
Yes.
Healed. Like magic.
The little ones have never had anyone to look to, except to me. And I am not much to speak of. You give them hope. And for this, I am grateful. I'll send something to demonstrate that gratitude.
I got a bonus already. Nice. A bonus after just one of the three in this area. Right, cool. By the way, I'd like to point out, I play these episodes, then I edit them. And in the editing process, I basically watch through the entire episode. So I get to witness all the story and info again. And then I get the feedback from actually uploading the videos in the comments section. So as I'm sitting here, I have a much better understanding now of Tenenbaum and so on. I don't know if I said this at some point, but I now know she was a prisoner in the Nazi prison camps. And she felt something akin to the tormentors, the Nazis. So we know that for a fact now. And then at some point, clearly, she underwent some sort of change, and now she feels something for these little sisters.
Sorry, let me try again.
Let's switch to normal shotgun ammo. Oh. If I can keep taking pictures, it means there's still damage increases I could get here, so... Oh! How did I do that? Oh! I mean, there's no reason not to. Ow. Oh, in the face. Right, I should have a bunch of dudes to loot here. I can't carry any more napalm. I need to craft some stuff then. First aid, dollars, kerosene. Cool. Well, it's nice to know these elite bouncers go down easy. Just like 10 shotgun shots. What's that? Oh, just regular. I want to know what the third bolt type is for the crossbow. Right, we haven't left the first room yet.
Welcome to the circus.
We're doing good. We're doing very good. Let's check the map real quick. Let's go down here. What did I just see? Did you see that? I'm gonna switch. I'm gonna get my exploding shotgun ammo out. I'm sure I just saw a shadow zip across. By the way, question. Somebody told me that. You know how I put all my guns in that pneumo tube for that boss that one time? And when I picked them all up, I already had a pistol, so it put the wrench in slot 2. And somebody in the comments let me know, you can't fix that. It's just fucked now forever. But I was thinking, that's... You know, most video games on PC have, like, config files you can edit if you want to. And this strikes me as the sort of thing that would be in a config file that I could literally edit with like, Notepad. So, question, does anyone know if that is actually possible? Oh, shit. There's the invent thing I was after. I'm gonna hack this because I'm gonna wanna... anti-personnel for the pistol, that's what I want. Let's hack the shit out of that. Electric gel is fantastic for Big Daddies. Kerosene and a nail. Right, the gel and the anti-personnel rounds use different shit. So, let's craft some AP rounds and some electric gel. And some more. Trap bolt! There it is! That's the third type. Tripwire bolts for the crossbow. These ingenious bolts shoot out an electrified tripwire when fired into a wall. I'm guessing it's the same thing that we've been moving dead bodies into to set off. I've got none, so let's craft 6 just to try them. And quick save. Okay. Well, made good progress this time. It's getting hard. The number of keys I've got to press to switch weapon on the keyboard is a pain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're on 8. I've got to really reach across to get that. Right, so we've got fire. I've got to try trap on like a regular guy first. Corridors is the perfect place to fire one of these. Have we got any splicers? Oh shit. Right, there's going to be something in there. Let me just, woof, woof. Woof, woof. Woof, woof. Okay, let's set this shit off and then stand still. Like a fucking boss. Stop touching me! I really do feel like this invisibility shit is like basically cheating. How can he see me? Right, the alarm's gone. I'll take that thing now. Fuck you! How did he see me? Interesting. The invisibility works well on like the robots and shit, but I was just stood there invisible and that splicer was on my ass. I love this, how much is that doggy in the window song? Ah, my childhood. Oh shit. Can we... I'm just gonna destroy this because I prefer destroying these to having them on my side, honestly. The loudness of them is just too annoying. Now, can I melt these with fire, then? Or they're not frozen? I think they're just, like, paper mache or something. How much is that dog in the window? Can I request a song? No. That looks like that is the exact statue or that looks exactly like Julie Langford, the tree woman. Tell me I'm not correct. That's exactly her, I think. Alright, let's get to looting. Can I play that again? I need more doggy in my life. How much is the... Oh, it's a different song. That Big Daddy doesn't have a little sister with him, does he? Yes, it is. I can hear it. I can hear him and her. Hang on, was it through where I was going? I can hear a thingy. I think it just goes through to the other area, doesn't it? So there's nothing else here, is there? Switch! Woo! I found a switch! Okay, this is kind of dark as shit. Like, talk about dark, dude. Oh, shit, man. Right, what are we gonna upgrade? I'm liking different weapons more and more. Like, I figured I'd stick with, like, a pistol, and then, like, you know, the grenade launcher, the chemical thrower, but I'm, like, I've started to really like the shotgun, for example. I do love me a good crossbow. I might have to go crossbow. And actually start using it. I prefer the chemical thrower to the grenade launcher, if I'm honest. I like spewing stuff rather than just throwing stuff. But then the crossbow. Come on, dude. Breakage chance. An automatic tension adjuster greatly reduces the chance of bolts breaking on impact. Oh! So you can pick your bolts up. increases the damage. Well, I might go with a breakage chance there, because if I lose a lot less ammo, I'm just going to go crazy with the crossbow. And damage won't matter as much. Let's do that. Let's just fire one at the wall.
Oh! Put it down!
Is this Doctor Who? Are these the Weeping Angels? What the fuck? Oh! Okay, this motherfucker's about to get a bolt to the face. Spider spot. Oh, it's just a regular spice. Ah! Got my bolt back. Nice. Okay, so the statues are coming back to life now. I figured all the statues were dead. Like, they'd killed the splicer and turned them into a statue. I guess not. Finally, I actually finished one. Thank Jesus. Nice, nice, nice. Anything else in this place? Just as they're even turning chairs into like papier-mâché statues. Have we got everything though? Well, I'm glad I found that little switch. Honestly. That was the tiniest thing. So easy to miss. Right, so what's the crack since we're back in this main room? You know what we're going to test? We're going to test the trip bolt. Trap bolt. Is that the little sister talking or a splicer? That's a... Right, where is she? I've got a trap bolt for one of you. That's not where I wanted that to go, but that worked out a treat. I figured it would go onto adjacent or, you know, if I like put it on this wall, it would zip directly across, but whatever works. My jeans are good for now. Well, that is just an instant kill, I think. I wonder how much damage that'll do to a big daddy. It might just stun him. Guns are blazing. Habana Especial cigars, those look luxurious to me. I'd love one of those.
The good people of Ratchet didn't sign up to see us government types shutting down shops, killing their owners. Even with a ponce like Fontaine. But he brung it upon himself. Instead of copping it on the chin, bugger gets it into his head that he's gonna go down guns blazing. Who does he think he is? John Bloody Wayne? We can get on top of this. We can. Here's what we do. We find Fontaine's will, and make what was his go to where it was intended, and not into the pockets of us that put him into the ground.
Right, apologies if you're gonna think I'm a moron here. I'm gonna replay that again and then walk through this area. I missed the first half of that, and it was important. It'll be Fort Frolic here.
The good people of Ratchet didn't sign up to see us government types shutting down shops
killing their owners.
Even with a ponce like Fontaine. But he brung it upon himself. Instead of copping it on the chin, bugger gets it into his head that he's gonna go down guns blazing. Who does he think he is? John Bloody Wayne?
So he's calling Fontaine.
We can get on top of this. We can. Here's what we do. We find Fontaine's will and make what was his go to where it was intended. And not into the pockets of us that put him into the ground.
I think I get it. McDonough's a good guy, and he's I don't know. Whatever was Fontaine's, he wants to give back to the people, etc. Right? Is that little sister with this big daddy? I think it was upstairs. No, it's not. I think he's trying to find her. Well, I'll leave him to his walking around. Let's get into this thing. I haven't found a code. I could just hack my way in, like a professional. But I kind of like the idea of finding the code somewhere. The only code to a thing I found yet was in the same room as it, so I don't know if some codes are far away or whatever. I wonder if the code is written somewhere. I'm not going to be a dick and try and search for it. It'll take 1,000 years. But I'll complete the rest of this area. Eve's garden. It's going all static in that. It usually means a ghost.
Well, if it isn't a long lost Andrew Ryan. Come here, tiger.
So Jasmine Jolene is clearly a, doesn't he have a wife? Ooh. Oh, is this like a strip? Right, I guess. Sorry, I get it. It's a stripper pole and shit. I'm picking up all the dollar bills. All the singles. Fantastic. I wish I could bust out some moves, but I don't think that's... Where's the next ghost? Oh.
I thought you had forgotten about poor Jasmine, but I am so glad you didn't.
It looks like Andrew Ryan is...
Sorry, Mr. Ryan, I didn't know. I didn't know Fontaine had something to do with it. What are you doing? No! No, don't, please! I loved you, don't, please, no! No!
I didn't know Fontaine had something to do with it. Hang on, is she one of the... Oh, I know, I need to post the photo. No. Right, now I was going to see if this is one of the three, but it's not. Oh, fuck me. Is this like... Is this where the dancers... The dancers make happy? Is this the hooker bed, basically? Fine Jen. That's it. What did she just say then? I didn't know Fontaine had something to do with it. Had something to do with what? I need to shut this up. I love the fact you can just whack it and it does actually shut up. That's just great. Interesting. So clearly I don't know everything to do with Fontaine and Ryan yet. Because I don't know what Fontaine supposedly did. Guess we'll keep learning. There's even like perfume bottles around. This is a proper hoe den. I wonder why Andrew Ryan killed her then. But maybe this'll tell. Oh shit. Pregnancy? Hang on. I need the dollars first. Right, let's learn more about this shit. Did Fontaine get her pregnant?
That creepy Dr. Tenenbaum promised me it wasn't going to be a real pregnancy. They'd just take the egg out once Mr. Ryan and I had... Oh, I needed the money so bad. But I know Mr. Ryan's going to suss it out. Going to know I wasn't being careful. Going to know I sold the... Mr. Ryan's going to be so mad at me.
There were several layers there. And as usual, I'm not sure I twigged what the fuck she just said. She got pregnant. It sounded like Andrew Ryan didn't know? I'm sorry. I know, it's this pain, but watching me listen to things that, you know, repeated times.
That creepy Dr. Tenenbaum promised
I'm reading it.
Gonna be a real pregnancy. They just take the egg out once.
So Tenenbaum promised her. Mr. Ryan's gonna suss it out.
No, I wasn't being careful. Gonna know I sold the... Mr. Ryan's
okay.
Gonna be so mad at me.
Tenenbaum. I like the fact the text stays here. Tenenbaum promised me it wasn't gonna be a real pregnancy. So, and Ryan would suss it out. So it looks like Tenenbaum wanted Jasmine Jolene, the hooker dancer person, to get specifically to get pregnant with Andrew Ryan's child, but Andrew Ryan didn't know. I know Mr. Ryan's gonna suss it out, and he's gonna know I wasn't being careful on contraception and shit, and he's gonna know I sold the child to Tenenbaum? Is this where we find out that all the little sisters are Andrew Ryan's children, technically? That's what I'm kind of getting from this. Maybe Tenenbaum was you know, without Ryan knowing, getting Ryan to get girls pregnant and buy the children off. That's what I'm getting from that. That's very interesting. Either way, Tenenbaum is clearly getting children for the little sisters, you know? And I don't know. He chose Ryan's children without even him even fucking knowing. Anything else in here? Anything else in here? No. Well, this is Jolene. 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 Jolene.
Fucking service around here.
Hang on, Rodriguez. Is that, it is Hector Rodriguez. It's one of the dudes. This guy's about to die a horrific bolty death.
Who does he think he is?
You're about to die, dude. Where are you running to? No, Big Daddy's gonna save you. Have a crossbow, but why is he running away?
What do you say, asshole?
I need to. Oh shit. He's gonna blow up. I might. You know what? I'm not gonna use the crossbow bolt because he's running away. I'll forget where all my bolts are. Get away! Get away! Oh, this guy's running straight back into the previous area. Oh, why is he so fast, man? Get on fire, motherfucker! I'm gonna stun the motherfucker. Jesus! Oh, he doesn't stun him. Oh my god, he's going everywhere. Oh, run past it. Quick, 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 quick. Okay, the shock bolt doesn't do shit anymore.
What do you say, asshole?
You're mine now, motherfucker. Let's use napalm. I don't want to freeze him and lose any loot.
He was a lout, but he was vigorous.
He was vigorous.
Before he completely dries up.
Yes, sir. Oh, this guy's actually torched because I used napalm. That's interesting. It says gather bolts. All in. So if you put multiple bolts into a dude, you can just click once and get all your bolts back. That's actually really cool. Old beer, right, okay. While he's still crispy. I'm gonna get all three kills before I go back to put the shit in the piece of art in the center, you know?
You flutter all around the fort, taking life as you go.
I'm a madman.
You're an angel. I've never painted an angel. Maybe I should.
If by paint you mean you're gonna kill me and turn me into a statue, you can fuck off. Why can I take more pictures of him? Okay. Right, that thing led me all over the fucking place. I need to get back to where I was. I have noticed there's a little. Oh, I remember. There's that room up there, but it was locked, and I couldn't get in there. So I'll leave it for now. I'm gonna go back because there's so much shit that I've left behind. I didn't think he would run all the way back to this place.
Diamond will fix me. Everything will work out.
Was it through here? Hang on, he completely fucking. No, it's not. He completely wrong-footed me.
I'm really crawling.
There it is. Poseidon Plaza. I want to get all three kills in this episode if I can. Hang on, it's not through there, is it? Or is it? Right, okay. So there truly was no way through to this area without unfreezing this door, which is interesting. Another bonus to damage? Again, maybe? Oh, shit. A physical tonic. What is it? You gain a great deal of health from snacks and bandages. I need to start buying more tonic slots, dude. After this episode, I'll have a real look. I'll have a real look at my tonics, etc. And slots. But I don't want to sit, like, for 20 minutes at a machine, subjecting you all to that. Right, I know there's a little sister upstairs, but there was so much back this way. Oh, he's looking for a little sister. Oh, she's... Okay, quick save. I might electric jail this one. Where's the pillars? I'll electric gel him, but I want to try the electric trap bolts. I need some pillars to work with. These will do. Hello. Hello. Everything is not safe. Let me prepare the thing onto electric gel. Good to go. It's a good idea to prepare all your, like, proper ammos that you want to use. Right. Okay, hang on. How are we going to do this? Hang on. I need to engage combat first. Whoa! This guy didn't give a fuck! Fuck! This guy didn't give a fuck! Fuck! Pillar. No, okay, this guy didn't give a fuck about electric things. He just stunned me then. The electric stuff is so great! Oh shit. Oh shit, man! Got him. That wasn't even 10 shots. Bubbles. Come back here.
Mr. Bubble!
I'm sorry. No. Let's rescue her before the other Big Daddy comes in.
No!
It's time to be free. Oh, he's upstairs.
You saved me.
I did. You're welcome. I don't want a repeat of last time when there was two Big Daddies I had to kill for the little sister. I think if a Big Daddy's just in the vicinity, they'll start protecting her.
Time for a nap, sweet angel.
Okay then, right, where are we? Where are we going? What are we doing? That thing. Why is there a pneumo tube here? What's this doing? And the corridor is grey, which leads me to believe there's something in this place still. By the way, there's a fucking leak. That's the end of Rapture right there. Ryan, look at this fucking place. It looks awesome. Fontaine Cream... Creams, pills, injections. So it looks like Fontaine has his fingers in all the pies. Medical stuff, Fontaine futuristics, so like science and technology. He was just everywhere. You got Fontaine at the top, Ryan in the middle, and Tom and Dave down the bottom. Should we just hack our way in? Let's stop being a Billy bastard. I've got this. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. I really think they missed a trick here by allowing you to hack them. I really do. I love finding codes in games. Let's not waste ammo here. Right, so what's in here that's worth taking? Other than a million cigars. There's got to be more. This is a whole lot of cigars, Jesus Christ. Any prompts? Any prompts at all? Just a lot of dollars, I think. I can hear the last little sister. It's nice that things you can loot usually shine and sparkle. Is she right outside? Is she outside?
Hurry, hurry, Mr. Bubbles.
Just like that, fucking quick save. The single pillar gave me a bit of a problem. I did get charged once.
Not a boy, spider.
Whoa! Where the fuck? Leave me alone! Jesus. I think that... Right, my money's full. I need to spend some. I did have a problem with the single pillar. He did manage to charge me once. Let's get in her face. Hello? Now that's a picture right there. Oh, let's take one more real quick. What do we get? Anything? Small increases to max health and needs. So that's a... It's just fantastic. Straight up. Let's prepare all the armor piercing shit. In fact, I'll do what I said I was going to do. Let's use the electric gel on this one.
Chocolate's better than grapes.
I want these two pillars worked brilliantly. Fuck me, that's loud. In my ears, at least. I need to come over here. Look how creepy the eyes are. Oh, itchy nose. Keep coming over here. We're doing good so far. Not even an hour into the episode, we've already got all three little sisters, basically. Now I'm going to count how much gel it takes to kill this thing. Let's start with one pistol shot just to open combat. Fuck! Oh! Can I keep tapping it? I'm just tapping it now. And it does do damage, I know it does. I love the way it... Let's hold it down a bit. You can stun it with a tap, which is great. This is using a lot more electric gel. Let's hold it down. This is using way more than it did on the Rosie. Got it. That used 100. That used so much more than it did on the other one. I've rescued your sisters, now it's your turn. Interesting if it turned out all these little girls were Andrew Ryan's daughters. That's just incredible. Oh, I need to spend money, and I've got 70 more dollars to loot here. It's expensive, but let's get one first. I'm gonna buy one tool. That'll let me loot to full. Cool. So yeah, I'm sure I killed the first. It was a Rosie Big Daddy, and I'm sure I killed it with 25 gel. I remember being shocked how fast I killed it. This one took 100. Now I don't know if that's because I was tap firing it, and you need to hold it down to ramp up the damage, perhaps. Interesting. Right, that's it. All three little sisters done. And now I can stop terrorizing the big daddies. Anything more to invent? I've looted a few more bits. I could make a bunch more electric gel since I just used over half of what I had. Let's do it. It seems so fucking... It's more useful... than anything for Big Daddy is because you can tap it and stun the Big Daddy. That's better than the shotgun electric ammo, even. I've got to. It's so useful. I can just take my time and laugh in the face of any Big Daddy, basically. Anyway, still don't know what the pneumo tube does. There's nothing else in there. Eve's garden. There was some more shit in here. Yeah, I never did loot this whole bar. Oh, tape. Hello.
You know what? Our music poetry.
This guy's pissed.
Tom Grift. Conan's got Ryan wrapped around his little pinky. Why? Because he tells him what he wants to hear. Rise, rapture, rise. Nuts. That stuff was still before it came out of Conan's pen. I'm through with the whole pinata. See that old fool trying to keep me here.
This is one of the three guys I've got to kill, Hector Rodriguez. You know, he just made a point there that a Cohen, this crazy artist, is just telling Ryan what he wants to hear. And I just had a sudden fucking flash of like a parallel in real life. It's an extreme example, but it's just what I thought of. Hitler. And it's not too much of a stretch in this game, Jesus Christ. Hitler and fucking dude who always wore the brown coats. What was his fucking name? Goebbels. Joseph Goebbels, whatever his name was. He was like Hitler's propaganda guy. And he was also like one of the top Nazi people. And I am no historian. But from what I understand, he was basically the king of all yes men. Like, he was sucking Hitler's cock in every meaningful way. And that sounded exactly like what he just said about Cohen, basically just saying exactly what Ryan wants to hear. I don't know why that came to my mind, but it did. That's what I imagine. Basically, Goebbels was like for Hitler. That's the weirdest thing to come to mind, but it did. Let's go down to $400 on the steel tip bolts. Like I said, I really want to start using this. I've wasted enough money on these motherfuckers, but let's waste one more dollar.
Well, I hope you have somebody to carry on your family name.
I do not. Right, anything else in here? I think we're good, but there's a back door we never went in. Is this like the penthouse suite or some shit? Oh, it's just upstairs. Oh, we're doing good. We're full on health and nearly full on Eve. We've got all the little sisters. This is definitely a high progress episode. Yeah. Ooh. I'm not so intent on searching every nook and cranny right now. Can I hack it real quick? Real quick, real quick! Ah! Why don't they let you hack? You know what I mean? I'm just gonna destroy it. I don't give a fuck. Oh! Stop to reload, why don't you? I don't know if you've got to stun them or something to hack them, but yeah. Oh, what was I saying? I was halfway through a thought. I'm not going to necessarily search every nook and cranny because with every area that I go in the game, I do like a big once-over. Once I know I'm about to leave the area, like in this area, the final thing will be going in that bathysphere that he stopped us going in to go to the next area of the game. And when that happens, I'll then do a massive once-over and edit it for YouTube so you don't see a lot of it unless I find tapes and shit. It lets me be a little faster when I'm actually playing through the area, which is cool. But that being said, I still want to look in most places. Right, okay. I need the money, and I'm invisible, so.
Vandalism is a serious crime. Remember, bandits are parasites.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Done, diddly done. Right. I don't know where Hector is. Maybe in this area in front of me somewhere. It's the last... oh no, sorry, I killed Hector. Who's the last one? Silas Cobb. Silas Cobb?
This diamond will fix me. Everything will work.
One time. Just one time. One more time. Just one final time. Fuck you. Let's try this one. And this one. Do it. More. More gambling. Ah, oh, for fuck's sake, they're just taking my money now. I just wasted anti-personnel ammo on that damned camera. Right, let's kill these guys with some style. Anyone else? Let's incinerate all these motherfuckers. Where are they? Was that only one person?
You're only making this hard for us both.
There's a guy angry somewhere, but I can't find him. I don't know where he is. One more. Come on. Oh, for fuck's sake. Fine, I guess I just won't gamble then. Let's try our best, eh? Oh, I love the easy ones when there's no, like, problems at all. Nice and easy. Right, where the fuck is this guy yelling? There he is.
You
what
want
the fuck is he doing, man?
Yeah, you know what? Actually, I've been waiting for a long time now.
What fucking weapon?
There's nothing down here.
What weapon is the heat-seeking missiles? I think it's this, isn't it?
Both.
I've got to kill this guy with spectacular fashion. Woo! Right, okay. So what's in this place then, eh? This is a very nice looking club for the, like, the 60s, I've got to say. What's this? Oh, Gene Bank. Okay, I definitely need to buy more slots. No tapes or anything up here? Oh, hello. Hello, tape. Put the bump.
This isn't some gangster or hard-nosed political operative. We're talking about a Dizzy Twist, what wrote a song or two that got under Ryan's wig.
Yes, that guy's so New York. He's more New York than anyone who lives in New York. Let this motherfucker get real close. Oh, look at the zoom on this. I didn't even realize that until now. What the? I think I hit this this thing here. Can I get my bolt back, please? Yes. Oh, Houdini. I tell you, that's an easy, fast way of killing the Houdini teleporter motherfuckers. Right, I think we're done here anyway. Yeah. Cool. Let's get out of here. I've already this is how my brain works. I've already forgotten what that tape just said to me. Fuck did it say? Oh, right. Right. So, yeah.
I just got the word to put the bomb on Anna Culpepper. This is
okay. So, Andrew Ryan.
Political operative.
Wow.
We're talking about a Dizzy Twist. scientist who had wrote a song or two that got under Ryan's wig.
So Andrew Ryan has got hitmen, official hitmen, killing women. Not killing anyone because of, like, I don't know, song lyrics and shit. That's crazy. Anyway, are we done with this area? Or is there more shit upstairs? Dude, these are so high damage. And I didn't even take the damage upgrade for the crossbow. That's one shot. And I missed like a fucking moron. Weird the way these guys run away. Okay, this is creepy. The fuck? Right, three shot kill. That's not bad. Without the upgrade, that's not bad. And I get the bolts back. Sander Cohen. Ooh! Ooh! But that looks like a trap to me! Okay.
You Cohen's messenger boy! I got enough for that crow.
I've got a crossbow for you, motherfucker.
Sugar.
A little time with my kittens. Did he call bombs kittens? What the fuck am I listening to? What am I listening to? Okay, this is all sorts of fucked. Oh, right, he's got soldier women. His kittens. Why is everyone in this town insane? Ha! Oh, what a reactive shot. Why is he setting fire to his own, like, women? Oh, there's milk sticks. Two little birds sucking on each other's piddle sticks. We've got a country boy. We've got New York boys. We've got country boys. I feel like I should be able to crawl through here, and there you go. I've missed some shit behind me. But I can't get up, so I'll be back. Ooh, I like the feel of the crossbow. Nice and sort of stealthy. Fuck me, is it dark? And we're back up again. Did I miss anything? I did. Right, we'll come back for that. Oh, that's it. Nice and easy.
It was a nasty one. And my
favorite.
But I think I like him better this way.
I like his pants.
Take his damn photo. Chop, chop.
Those are some bright ass pants. Oh, hang on. I'm trying to move his body. All right. Let's have a photo of those pants. Whoa, Nelly! Fuck you! Did I loot everything? Yeah, cool. Right, that big daddy, those are so fucking loud. But let's play this tape.
Cohen's not a musician. He's Ryan's stable boy. Ryan's corrupt policies crap all over the place, and Cohen flutters around clearing it up. But instead of using a shovel, like you would with a proper mule, Cohen tidies with a catchy melody and a clever turn of phrase. But no matter how nicely it sounds, he can't really do anything about the smell.
This lady was the one who had a hit put out on her by Andrew Ryan. Clearly, because she's talking shit about Andrew Ryan. As she should. Oh, shit.
Cohen's not a musician.
You can't cancel. I didn't mean to replay it.
Ryan's corrupt policies crap all over the place.
Crap.
Cohen flutters around clearing it up. But instead of using a shovel, like you would with a proper mule, Cohen tidies with a catchy melody and a clever turn of phrase. But no matter how nicely it sounds, he can't really do anything about the smell.
She got killed, I guess. Why is it saying unknown item? Strange. I think we're done here. Let's get out of here again. I wanted to get as far from the Big Daddy while playing the tape as possible. Otherwise, they're too fucking loud. Right, so there's a room I hadn't been in over here, I believe.
Welcome to the Circus of Value.
I'm getting all my bolts back. Don't even need to buy them. I want these dollars, these couple of dollars, so I'll skip ahead. But they can't see me. I swear sometimes they can see you and sometimes they can't. I guess I won't skip ahead. Oh. Or maybe certain types of splicer can see you when you're invisible, maybe. Oh, they're creepy. They're like horror film, I don't know. Creepy crawlies. Look at them. Look at them. She won't stand still, man. Fuck off. 1 second left. Right, that's it. Good. I want that. Come to me. And I want those couple of dollars. It's worth it. I do have all three for... Yeah, I've got all three now, so I can go back now. So I know where I need to go, but I need to, like, complete this area.
And the theater woman gets used to attention.
Who am I listening to? Let's just hide for a second. I don't know if these are pissed off at me or them. I'm gonna let them kill each other.
Where are you going, honey?
I'ma just let them kill each other.
I'm a star, not
damn it!
You.
Burn them all! Let them burn! Good enough. Okay, so what the fuck is this place? Oh, is it just connected downstairs? Never mind. I could have come in here any time. Why can I hack a destroyed bot? That's a bit weird. Okay. Fontaine's army.
Fontaine knew our blokes were coming. We were done over. Splicers come screaming out the woodwork, burping fire, spitting ice, demons out of the Bible they were. I've never seen nothing like it. It wasn't a business he was building, it was an army.
I see. Okay, things are starting to... That's actually a really important tape right there. Fontaine was building an army of plasmid, atom-riddled motherfuckers, some with fire powers, some with ice powers. Very interesting. Very interesting. I wonder if Andrew Ryan was doing the same thing. Because I know that do the Big Daddies and Little Sisters have much to do with Andrew Ryan? They seem to just be Tenenbaum's way of getting Adam. Because that's a piece of info I did retain from the last episodes. Is that the point of the Little Sisters completely, they were created solely as a way of harvesting more Adam. Because when you mix the sea slug with a human host, you get 20 to 30 times more Adam. And that's why Tenenbaum created the Little Sisters. So I guess they don't really have much to do with Andrew Ryan. But Tenenbaum has some powerful Big Daddies working for it, you know what I'm saying? And then Fontaine had his army of plasmid motherfuckers. What does Andrew Ryan have? Top right, top right, top right, top right, bottom left, bottom left, bottom left. Done. Interesting though. So Font, it really does feel like Font. Andrew Ryan is like powerful somehow. He's got all the security systems and cameras and shit on his side. But it seems like in every other way, Fontaine is the power behind this place. He is so gonna pop up like towards the end of the game. There's no way he's not living still. Have we got everything here? I think so. Oh, nice. Damn it, come on. We'll round this episode out, I think, by putting our shit in. Putting the photographs in the artwork and continuing. Just want to make sure I've got everything here. We'll do the I'll do the complete, proper, in-depth once-over a bit later on. I think we've nailed both these areas, although there is that whole fucking place I haven't been in. Let's go there real quick. Hang on. This stairs here goes to there, and then that stairs there goes to there. Okay.
A rapture reminds us. We all have a day. And the temptation to break curfew to make a little extra added is
great. Oh, right. Sorry. I was confused at where we actually were. Fucking hell, it is a one-shot kill. Oh, fuck's sake, that was a waste of a bolt. Okay. Yep, I've done everything. Let's go down here, and then it should be... Fucking hell! I tried shooting it preemptively. Didn't work. And then it's up these stairs here, or down here. Right, okay. I haven't been in here, have I? What is in here? Just a bunch of headless mannequins. I don't mind them without the head. I have a thing about mannequins. I don't like them. There's got to be some serious shit about to go down. Oh my god. These are all going to come to life. I know it. Quick save. Whew. So, extra nutrition too. Gain extra health from snacks and bandages, it's all good. Is that it? I really thought shit was gonna come back to life. A room this big with its own, like, whole location. There's gotta be more than meets the eye in here. This is creepy as shit, man. Oh! What just happened then? I had the notion of putting the head on the body. I just did. It felt like a funny thing to do. Did I make that motherfucker come back to life? Or was that one that I saw over there teleporting? I guess I didn't. I thought I did something. I've got a hat. Can I put a hat on one of these things? Whoa. Oh, fucking... Where the fuck are these guys coming from, man? Jesus Christ. Just fucking in my face, not 2 inches from my face. Where the fuck? Jesus. Ow. Oh, these guys don't give a fuck. Let's try taking a picture of something. That might reveal. Where the fuck are these guys coming from? There's just one stood here as a statue again. Oh, Jesus. Oh, got him. Nice. Good. 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 Yes. Yes. Are there any more? Very interesting. Oh, fuck. Ooh, those are cool looking weapons. Where did he go? What is this of a fight? This is a creepy ass room. I've proper got chills and goosebumps here. So those mannequins... I'm confused. The mannequins didn't have heads, but it looks like they've all turned into people because they've all disappeared. Are we good to get out? That's, I mean, the camera's a good tool of when there's something around, like. If there's an enemy anywhere, it starts to spin. Interesting, I didn't know you could zoom. With a right click, that's how you do that. Okay, well, room complete, I guess. That was fucking creepy. Okay, we're never coming back. What the fuck? Right, let's go put our pictures in, see what rewards we get. We did get a reward after putting the very first one in. Like, just the first one. I wonder if we get, like, three rewards. That's right. Is it up or is it down? It's down, isn't it?
Hey, Barry. What's with the sourpuss?
Have you heard what's going
on? What's my money looking like? Ooh! Nearly full. I've got a lot of Adam, I've just realized. I need to spend some of that shit. By the way, didn't, like, on the rescuing the very first little sister in this episode, didn't Lady tell me there would be a gift? There it is. Yeah. Now we've got even more Adam. 200 Adam, hypnotized Big Daddy 2. I wish it would tell me what that is. 440 Adam. I might as well use it now before anything goes down. I'm tempted to try some new plasmids and shit. But I want at the very least one more slot in every slot. You know what I mean? Each of the three things, physical, engineering, combat, I've got 3 out of 6. I need at least one of each type. Fine. And then they disappear, so it's worth getting. I would really love to use some that I have but can't, you know? Nice. And I'll change them all, the ones that I've got equipped, after the episode, but before the next one. But is there anything else I want to buy? I could just go with straight up another Eve upgrade. I kind of think upgrading some shit, might be worth getting. Like, Insect Swarm 2. I don't have Insect Swarm fucking 1. I'm sure I never got an Insect Swarm 1, so... Interesting. Increases heat of fire, like, more fire damage might be worth it. I am using quite a lot of fire now. But then I've got the, napalm thrower. Meh. And I've got so much ammo with that. Because I love the idea of being a Jedi, I might go with, like, Sonic Boom. I've got enough to buy either Eve upgrade, boom. And then I might... Do I need to buy Sonic Boom 1? That's the question. Let's just buy 2. And I don't care about the security bullseye. Get rid of that shit. Do I get a video showing me what to do? Or... I guess not. Sonic Boom. Oh! I don't know why I didn't get the first one, to be honest. I think I always spent all the Adam before I could, like, afford it. Right, let's put that shit in, shall we?
Can anyone ever make you feel like Senator Cohen can? Rapture's
most
beloved.
Right, let's do this.
Returns with why?
Is it him?
Is it cool?
You?
Let's try the Sonic Boom. Oh my god, I'm gonna enjoy this. It killed them! I figured it would just be like more of a utility. Like you could just, it would be like a knockback effect in like World of Warcraft or something. Just, it would knock them back but not do damage. And it would be more helpful, you know? Just clear the area, get some distance from the enemies. But that killed her in one? Oh, that's right up there with telekinesis then. If you can force... Telekinesis is just Jedi force lifting and shit. And Sonic Boom is Jedi fucking explosion. Force explosion. That's... automatically become one of my favorite plasmids. That's great. If I can kill with sheer force powers. Right, let's put each one in.
It's coming together.
Yes.
But there will always be doubters. You don't doubt me, do you? I could never
stop. I do doubt you.
Doubters.
I will always doubt you, you motherfucker. I'm sorry, I need to kill whoever the fuck is crying. Where's the crier? I don't like being interrupted during, like, story moments and shit. You understand? Alright, let's put, so what is it? Gift. Oh, just nice stuff. Okay. Cool, right. Picture number two.
That's three of four. What's that look? You don't like it, do you? I don't need to be judged by you, by anyone. Screw you! Screw all you fucking doubters! Here's what I say to all of you!
Okay, this on 3 out of 4, he's officially lost his shit.
Fly away, little moth! Fly!
Why can't I put number four in? I'm invisible. Oh, hang on. Hang on. I said at the start of this episode, somebody warned me that with this invisibility shit on, something in Fort Frolic bugs out. And he warned me to maybe remove it during this segment. I'm not going to stand invisible. I'll just insta-kill them with force blast. That's ridiculous, dude. It's better than telekinesis. I love this. Why didn't I get Sonic Boom earlier? Listen to the music. This is such fitting, awesome music. Is that instant kill?
Smile!
Oh, dude. Such elegant music to be force blasting people. Force push. That's the term I was looking for. For like force blasting someone. I think it's officially a force push. It uses a lot of... Oh, shit, man. Shit, man! I can't believe... Ooh, I wonder if you can hit one into another. Oh, let's loot these real fast. Oh, I'm loving this. Right, I can't have them too close, or otherwise it doesn't work. Come at me, bruh. Defeat Cohen's spices.
Sorry for that outburst. You'll have to forgive an old fool his artistic temperament. The birth is so close now. The labor pains can blur the judgment and drive the passions of even the finest spirits.
I wonder why the waves of shit happens on 3 out of 4 photos. I was sort of expecting like a wave of enemies on all three, but hey. So yeah, the force blast thing doesn't work if they're like point blank range. It sort of bugs out a little bit, but otherwise it's fucking powerful. And I've just learned that defensive when you get hit, there's the shockwave thing that happens. I didn't know that kills weaker enemies outright, but it does. And I've just seen these motherfuckers. Ain't no hacking this one. Or using this one, even. Hang on. Cohen's Muse lockbox. When the fuck did I get a key for this? Oh, I guess I don't have a key for it. Okay. Maybe something I'll find in my big, thorough search of the area. Right, let's quick save and complete his artwork after we quickly check this out. Oh, that's the way back to the bathysphere. Okay, never mind. There is all this shit down here that I never, ever accessed. Jesus, that's close. Well, assuming all hell doesn't break loose after I put this picture in, I should be free to search more of the area, you know what I'm saying? So I will I'm going to blast a main save here, just in case I am somehow forced out of the area without completing it. Weird that there's a full area to go still, but let's do this. I need to spend my dollars. I'm wasting money. It's a vending machine to waste money on. Was it through here? I just need to waste money on anything. I need more even health and shit. I haven't used any fireballs yet. Might be worth a few. I want to try the sonic boom on a Big Daddy, I won't lie. Here we go.
It is...
Hello!
Accomplished!
Hello! Okay, I won't immediately kill him.
My God.
Okay. I'll give him a few minutes to live.
It's beautiful.
You'll find your path to Ryan is now clear.
Okay.
Sanders said hello. Oh, yes. You may avail yourself upon one of my lesser works as a token of our time together.
Oh.
If you had become my one and true disciple, you might have been worthy of seeing inside the box of my most private muse. But who knows if that man is yet even born. Now, go.
So he's gifting me this.
What happened to you? I've been trying to raise you for a dog's age. Never mind. Would you kindly leg it over to the sphere and get on down to Hephaestus? It's time to settle up with Ryan.
I will, but there's like 1,000 things I need to do first. He's just... There is some ominous... Do you hear the ominous background music or whatever you call it? Ambience. And he's gifted me this, but he's specifically... clearly, I think I can kill him if I want to. This seems like an important decision somehow, and I'm guessing once you kill this guy, if you want to kill him, he'll have the key to his most secret muse. Let's save it. I don't go back on choices. So if I choose to kill him and then something, again, it's like a bad thing. I'll continue. I don't know. Clearly, he's got the key to this. Let's take this real fast. First aid kits, I'll store and figure that out later. Do we kill him? He looks interesting though, with his giant bright face. Oh god. I don't just want to kill him, but at the same time, he's killing people. I feel like it's literally a good thing to kill him. Otherwise he'll just keep killing. Do we kill him and take his most secret thing?
Don't fucking judge me!
Oh, you can force blast grenades. Oh my god. Can I get somebody else to kill him? Can I cheat this?
I didn't touch her.
Can I get him to grenade?
I'm not a bad person!
Kill you! Can I? Oh, this is interesting. I wonder if I can get somebody else to kill him.
I didn't mean to hurt anyone.
Over here, dude. Oh, that would be the world's greatest.
I just wanted some company.
Really?
You betcha. Riot Industries has seen to it that they're bred to be as.
I guess he can't get hit by it. Right, okay.
We've had
wasn't enough. Shit.
Jeez, this guy's tough as shit, man. Do we kill him? He has killed, you know what, let's kill him. He's killed all sorts of people. I'm sitting here, I need to end the episode, but... do we kill him? He has killed so many people. I'm tempted to leave him, honestly. He's a maniac, and but maybe he'll stop being a maniac now his thing is complete. What do you think? Let me know down in the comments. I can always hopefully come back and kill him. I think I'll leave him for now. I'm going to end the episode there. Well, thanks for joining me for this episode. It's been a doozy. I got a lot done in this episode. At the start of the next episode, I'll do the once over of the whole fucking area, and, you know, cut out everything except, you know, whatever I find, tapes and shit. So that's next episode. And then we take the Bathysphere, to Hephaestus and go kill Ryan. Let me know in the comments if I should kill this motherfucker. It just feels like one of those things that's a big deal. Clearly, he will drop the key to that thing. And I'm curious as to what's inside, but curiosity did kill the cat. So, I don't know. Maybe something bad will happen in, like, down the line if I kill him now. His life is in my hands. Even if he's killed other people, it's still sort of evil to kill him. Which is why I think I'm leaning towards letting him live. My weaponry and powers are awesome enough. I don't really need whatever the fuck is in that thing. Anyway, like this vid if you liked it, like this vid if you didn't like it, and subscribe for similar content. I have Facebook, Twitter, Discord, all the links in the description, and I also have a Patreon if you want to go above and beyond to support the games that I'm playing. I need to buy Resident Evil 4 the remake next, and that's expensive as shit. Anyway, catch you guys in the next episode. Liquid Blitz, out.